Come on.
Whether knowingly or unknowingly, God will still restore you right where you live.
Right where you are.
Yes.
That's one thing about God. He don't make you go back to the beginning.
That's right.
And the Bible tells us, as Christians of the Most High God, he who are spiritual,
yes,
restores such a one.
Yes.
It doesn't matter. It does not matter. As long as you chose wisely, as long as your choice is heartfelt, as long as your choice is for God and God alone.
Yes.
Because the world does not mean us any good. Anyway, we ain't going to fit in anyway. We don't. Because if you've been in this walk as long as I have and as long as some of you have, and you try to go back out in the world, it's not going to work. Because the things that you used to do when you weren't saved, they ain't doing that no more. All that, the cabbage patch and all that stuff, now that they're doing, they ain't doing that now. They're not doing that. Amen. They ain't doing that. They doing the whip and the nay nay now. Amen. So, you ain't going to fit. So, you might as well choose God.
Amen.
Where you know that you're always going to fit. And if you don't fit, we serve a living God that's so merciful and so loving that he would put us back on the pilot's wheel. And he would get all those mars and scratches and ugly stuff of the world that they have put up on us. He would put us back on the pilot's wheel and clean us up. He would clean us up and replace us right where we left off. Come on and give God some praise for being a merciful God. Amen. We are going to make the right decisions.
Amen.
Let me leave you with a few quotes and then I'm going to sit down about life and about making decisions. It says, your life is a result of choices you make. If you don't like your life, if you don't like the way your life is, it's time to start making better choices. Life is a choice. It's full of them. The more we know this, the more power we gain in living a life of meaning rather than living a life of obligations. So don't serve God out of obligation. Serve him out of love. I always say I don't ever want to be nowhere where I'm just tolerated.
Amen.
I want to be where I'm appreciated.
Amen.
If you tolerate me, guess what? I won't be around too long because I know who I be.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
I know my value.
Amen.
Because I'm a child of the Most High God, not only because of a family, but because of the God that's in me. I know who I am in Christ, and I know whose I am in Christ.
Amen.
So if you got to tolerate me, bye. I'm going to say bye, Felicia. No, one last quote. The more we rely on God to guide our life choices, the less frustration and chaotic our lives will become. The more we rely on God and guiding our choices and handing our lives over to the Lord, the less chaotic and confusion there will be in our lives. And I thank God for having a sound mind. The scripture says he will keep us in perfect peace if our minds stay on him. Amen.
Amen.
I want to give God a hand.
Amen. Amen.